when I saw the idea that you just saw, if you're a guest and you were invited in this room, would you raise your hand, please? Okay, fantastic. So to my guests, let me just say to you that what you're experiencing right now is very unique, because you're actually, you're getting the fullest experience of this when you're seeing it for the first time. When I saw it, I actually was sitting on somebody's couch and I saw the idea. And at that point in my life, I was speaking professionally and traveling mostly in the United States, doing Fortune 500 and Fortune 50 companies and pharmaceuticals. And before I got into speaking, I was in entertainment. So I had been on Broadway, I had done films and television, and I made my living traveling, bless you, from Europe, you know, to the United States doing theater and doing what I love to do. So I wasn't in a space where I was looking for anything. It just so happened that the person who invited me to look at it, he and I were business partners, and I was like, cool, let me take a look and see what's going on. Now, my ego, when I saw this idea, was like this. And my bank account was not bad either, but I was intrigued by the idea of working as a team. I grew up playing sports. So I identified with teamwork and making people better. And if I'm not better, then you can't be better. So I love the concept of coming together as a unit to do something significant. So I had to make some decisions for myself that I was going to be willing to go on this adventure, not knowing where it was going to take me. Unfortunately, I only saw enough of this idea to enroll, to get signed up. But I didn't see enough to get started. For most people, they have two dates, and sometimes three. The date that you see this idea, and you make a decision that you want to be a part of it. And then there's a date that you decide that you actually want to do something with it. And you want to get started. And then there's a third date. And that's when you discover that you have untapped capacity inside of you, and you can take this thing to places you never imagined. Very few people reach that third date. Very few people reach the second day. Everybody's gonna have the first day where you get started, you enroll. So it took me about 6 months to kind of figure out what was going on. And I remember specifically having a conversation with Oz, and he had no idea that this was going on. But he was talking to me and he was sharing with me things specifically about the business and where we could go and how it was going to grow. And I was just sitting there like this. I was just nodding my head like this. I had no idea what he was talking about. It just went right over my head. But I didn't want to say that because I didn't want to look like I didn't know what, you know, he was spending a lot of time and energy talking to me. So I didn't want him to feel like he was wasting his breath, but he really was. But what happened was, I went to events like this. And I got on conference calls, and I started becoming a detective, just kind of snooping around and getting into people's stories. And the more I learned about other people's journeys, the more I began to see the possibilities for my journey. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
See, when you're in a room like this, especially if you're a guest, you can't deny what's happening. You can't look at someone that's living and breathing right in front of you and say, hey, listen, tell me your story. And he tells you his story, and you're like, wow, that's what you've created so just in that little bit of time? Well, man, if he's doing it, maybe I can do it too. And so I started to open my eyes to greater possibilities. But I had some very strategic advantages. Everybody in this room you have gifts that you've been given. There are things inside of you that no one else has but you. And the way that you share that, the way that you express that, you're going to find thousands and thousands and thousands of other people that resonate with how you express your best self. So, my strategic advantage was this. How many of you all know people and they get into a relationship with the wrong person? And then the person that you know, their life goes like this. Y'all know people like that? Yeah. How many of you all know people that get into a relationship with the right person and everything they do just goes up?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes, definitely.
Most people spend time with the wrong people. Think about it like this. Your Fab Five. Okay, I call it your Fab Five. The five people that you spend most of your time with, that you choose to let into your life, that's going to determine your level of success, your level of health, your level of income, and impact over the next 5, 10, 15 years. Think about the five people that you choose to plug into for the majority of your leisure time right now. And when I thought about that, I was like, I need a new five people. It's not that I don't love these five people, but I need new five people because I don't want to stay where we're at. I want to go somewhere different. How many of you all want to go somewhere different in your life? See, we've been programmed and conditioned by certain things in our lives. There are things we've been exposed to, the house you grew up in, the culture that you have been taught in, the language that you speak, the music that you resonate with, the clothing that you wear, the food that you eat. All of these things have been conditioned in us. And somewhere along the line, every one of you started speaking a different kind of story. You said, Mom, I don't want to wear that outfit. I want to wear this outfit. And I don't want to listen to that kind of music anymore. I actually like this kind of music. And I don't want to eat that food. I like this kind of food. And some of you all were very strong in that. And some of you all were not. You said, I don't want to wear that. I want to wear this. Well, no, you're wearing that. And you were like, okay. I don't want to eat that. Well, you're going to eat it anyway. Okay. I don't want to hang around those kind of people. Well, you're going to hang around them because that's just the way it is. This is how it was in my family, before your grandparents and your great-grandparents. This is how we always done it. This is how you're going to do it. And you were like, okay. So when you see an idea like this, you come into a room like this, it can be a shock to your system. It can threaten your entire way of life as you know it. And even though we're asking you, hey, do you like to travel? You like vacations? You like having fun? You're like, yeah, I do. How would you like to take more trips and spend more time with your loved ones and see more of the world? Yeah, I would. And what if you could actually get paid for it? Oh, that would be awesome. Yeah, that's really cool. And then it comes time to get started and you're like, your whole being is like, but that's impossible. That's not how I grew up. Nobody ever told me I could travel the world and get paid for it. Who told me I could spend more time with my loved ones and create more memories? That doesn't make sense. Yes, I like it, but I can't. You're threatening my whole way of life, Ed! And so the realm of possibility for you becomes a scary proposition. So my advantage was this. One thing, and there are a couple of things that I know I'm here for. There are a couple of things that I'm absolutely 100% clear why I am here. But there's some other things I'm still trying to figure out. Here's what I'm really good at. I'm getting close to mastering it. I know how to surround myself with the right people. I know how to follow the right leadership. I know how to listen, and I know how to be coachable. So what happened with me, when I got started with this, my first question was, who's doing it at a really, really high level? I'm not talking to my mama. I ain't talking to my best friend. I'm not talking to whoever I'm dating. I'm not going to go ask my neighbor, hey, tell me what you think about this. No. I want to know who's been in it and who's winning at a high level. I'm going to find out what they did, and then I'm going to do what they did, and I'll do more of it. So my advantage was unique in that I just made a choice to plug into that. So when I had a relationship, started building a relationship with Owens and Michael, they had experience in business. They had a track record. And even though I didn't understand a lot of stuff that they may have been sharing with me, I knew that they knew something I didn't. So I got a chance to kind of watch them. And I watched how they built something and they created this energy. And I was like, okay, well, that's possible. Okay, it can be done. And I was very fortunate because Johnny Wimbrey and I had been speaking together. So when he introduced this concept to me, I already knew he was successful in it. I didn't know how. I just knew he was successful. Johnny Wimbrey connected me to Matt Morris. Now, do you understand between Johnny Wimbrey and Matt Morris, and these are two very successful businessmen, they have more than 33 years of experience and results in this idea, this business model. So I knew that if I just stayed close to them, I was going to be okay. Was I uncomfortable? Yes. Now here's the crazy thing. Even though I was surrounded by that kind of experience and leadership, I was still fighting it. I was still resisting. I was still kind of like, all right, I'm going to watch you all. I know you want me to do this, but I'm just going to kind of hang back. You know what the problem with success is? Success. You know what the problem with recognition is? Recognition. As soon as you've done something, you can easily fall into the trap of, okay, I'm good, I know what I'm doing. And that's when it's like, lights out, you're done. So my problem was, I was like, well, I'm good, you know. I mean, I got residual income from film and television I've been doing, and my speaking business is going well. Like, you know, I'll just kind of sit back and watch. I was really, really cool. I was so cool.
I do see.
And I was missing the boat. I was missing opportunity. There were people that were coming into my life, and I didn't show them. I didn't invite them to look at it because I was too cool. I was like, yeah, wait, well, I'm going to, you know, take my time. I'm good. And because I was in that space, things were just passing right over my head, passing right by me. I literally lost thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars because I was being cool. See, you've been living your life a certain way for the majority of your life. And even those of you that have been exposed and involved with this idea for a few months or a few years, you still have all of this from your previous years that you have to contend with. remember I took a trip. My first time out of the country, I went to Russia. I was at the St. Petersburg Drama Academy. I was performing at the Alexandrinsky Theater, and I had never gone out of the country, so I didn't understand, you know, luggage, right? So I had all these pieces of luggage, 5, 6, 7 bags, because I was there for about 6 weeks. And I remember checking in, and the lady behind the desk said, hey, you're going to have to pay extra for all this extra baggage. I was like, what do you mean I got to pay extra? She's like, well, you got to take money out your pocket, you got to pay. You don't pay, you don't take the luggage. I was like, I didn't budget for that. This is my lunch money. That's too bad. So I had to pay and use my lunch money for all this excess baggage. See, when you have excess baggage in your life, there's a cost that comes with it. And most people are carrying around all this luggage, and they're dragging it behind them. It's like, yeah, my mama didn't love me enough. My daddy didn't like me. My brother and sister abused me. I was told I wasn't going to be much. I look around and nobody else is doing anything, so what makes me think that I can do something? Everybody in my family, they're living paycheck to paycheck. That's what's supposed to be for me too. And so you got all this baggage. I know that this person can do it, but that's not me. I don't have this. I don't have that. It's baggage. It's not what you don't have. It's what you think you need that will keep you from achieving your goals and fulfilling your highest life. It's not what you don't have. It's what you think you need that will prevent you from achieving your goals and fulfilling your highest life. So it took me some time to kind of get through all that stuff that was going on up here. But once I got it, I got it. So, to my guests in the room, it's a unique concept because you have an opportunity to learn and learn something new about you. And you know what happens when it's time to learn something new? You have a physical, biological reaction to it. You do, and I'll tell you why. In the brain, in the mind, you have these things called dendrites. And they are connecting, and they form pathways. So the messages are sent. And because certain messages are sent, like you got up this morning, and you probably, you know, brushed your teeth, and you washed up or whatever, it's been habituated in your pattern. You have certain thoughts that you think, oh yeah, I love this kind of food. And when I hear that music, oh, that song right there, I love that song. It just makes me want to, and these are certain patterns that are formed, right? So now all of a sudden, somebody comes into your brain space and they say, you can do whatever you want to do. You can make whatever income you decide you want to make. If you're willing to follow this system and be coachable, you can literally travel around the world and earn millions of dollars while you're doing it. And you're like, that sounds good, but I've never experienced it. I've never done that. I probably never even thought about doing that. And so you start trying to go in a new direction of thought, and these are new thought patterns. So the dendrites are—they're new. There's no familiar track. It's a brand new thought pattern. So they're like this. They're really far apart, and you're like, I think I can. I think I can. I think I can. And it's like they're trying to connect, and then all this baggage, all this self-talk starts to come in between. You can't do that. You a fool. You ain't never made that much money in your life. What are you talking about? Don't you know that's a pipe dream? Don't you know that's one of those things? don't you know that they're all high on Kool-Aid? And so the dendrites, you start interrupting the pattern, and then you're like this. Whew, man, I almost learned something. That was close. You go back over here and I'm comfortable. Right, to be happy is it's comfortable, it's familiar. I know I'm not living the life that I want. I know I'm not making all the money that I want, but I'm familiar and I'm comfortable. And I feel safe. And see, safety is dangerous because we have an instinct to be safe. And there's two kinds of safe. There is the kind of safe where you're walking down the street and it's 12 o'clock at night and you're by yourself and you see two shadowy figures, can't even make out their faces, and they're walking and something's hanging from the side. It's kind of shiny, you can't really see what it is. And they're walking like this towards you. And you sense it because you got about 100 yards. You can see them, but they're not super close, but you can see them. You see this thing shining. And there's a safety thing that kicks in. You're like, oh, this might be dangerous. I see somebody walking. I'm just going to turn and go this way because there's more people over here. There's a crowd. Oh, there's a cop car. I'm going to walk towards that cop car. That's called common sense safety. Yes?
Yes.
There's another kind of safety switch that kicks in, though. It's when you get exposed to a new idea. It's when someone shares a new concept with you. It's when someone challenges you to think beyond your current circumstances, to dare, to dream bigger than maybe you ever have in your entire life. Now you're like, you have the same reaction to the two menacing figures coming at you. You have the same reaction to greater possibility as you do to imminent danger. And you do the exact same thing. You walk the other way. I don't want any part of that. That's success. I don't want none of that. Isn't that crazy? This is what people do. My thought is this. What's the worst that can happen? Like, really? I end up in a room full of awesome people in Israel. I have relationships that will be with me for the rest of my life because of this idea, because I said yes to greater possibility. I've made a ton of mistakes, but I've learned so much in a short period of time. And I can tell you this. From a four-year degree, I have an honors degree from Morehouse. I have a terminal master's degree from Yale University. Can't go get any higher than what I got. That's 7 years of schooling. I've studied in Oxford. I've studied in St. Petersburg in Russia. And I am telling you right now, what I have learned in a two-year period. And this idea is 10 times more potent and valuable to my life experience than what it took me 7 years to accumulate in a formal education model. What's the worst that can happen? You expand your possibilities. See, you don't get in life what you want. You get in life who you are. If you come into a presentation or an event like this, and you're kind of sitting there, and you're like, yeah, what do they got to show me? Yeah, I've seen these things before. Everybody's all happy. What's wrong with these people? If this is how you are, this is what you're going to get in life. This is what you get. There's an interesting proverb. It says, to he who has, he will be given more. To he who hath not, even that which he hath will be taken away. Okay? So, whose cup is this? I need an empty cup. Give me an empty one. Is that empty one? This one empty? So that bothered me. That idea bothered me because I was like, wait a minute. So you're saying if I have, then I'm going to get more, but the person over here that doesn't have, even what he has is going to be taken away? That's not fair. Bothered me. I had to meditate on that for a while. I was like, that doesn't make any sense to me. Why is that? And then I understood something. See, when your cup is right side up, you can receive. And as you receive, you can do one of two things. You can, pour some out to make room for more. And when you pour out, what you're doing is you're pouring into someone else. You have some of that. You're pouring into somebody else. Because you got something that's good, right? And now guess what? There's room for more. To him that hath, more will be given. Right? Because your cup is runneth over. My cup runneth over. So you're pouring out. Now, to him that hath not. Because a lot of people are walking around with the same cup, but it's turned upside down. They can't receive anything. They can't get anything new in terms of their life experience. And even that which they have is going to be taken away because they are living in lack and limitation and low expectation. And when you think like that, you're going to get more and more of that in your life over and over and over again because your cup is upside down. How many of y'all know people that walk around with their cups upside down? Mm-hmm. Those that didn't raise your hand, you the one. No, I'm just kidding. So, being mindful of that is important. Because it's really the only way that you're going to progress. I look at this idea, it's like a vehicle. I'm not into the, you'll never hear me say that World Ventures is the greatest company in the world. I'm not going to say that. I think that's foolish. It's arrogant. I think it's a simple vehicle to get you from point A to point B a lot faster than whatever vehicle you're driving now. Now, I do think that we have some of the most amazing people in the world. I do think we have some of the best leadership and training in the world, because I've been exposed to a lot of different training events and models, if you will. So I've seen a lot of what people consider to be the best, and I'm very confident that we're up there with anyone else that you can point out that's doing this thing at a high level in terms of training and leadership and development and quality people. Mm-hmm. See, the room that you're sitting in, again, if you're a guest, you actually have access right now to some very, very high caliber, successful, quality people. If I were you, I'd take advantage of that. Because I don't really, it doesn't matter what you do for your career, what you're here for in terms of your life, whatever your purpose is. Here's what I am 100% certain about. Whatever you allow yourself to experience in this world here, will have a dramatic, positive impact on your world out there. No matter what you do. Mm-hmm. See, you can be a part of this idea, and maybe you don't want to make $1 million a year. Maybe you just want to make a few hundred. I don't know. But I do know this, the value proposition in terms of what you get in training and information for your life development is invaluable. You cannot put a price tag on it. That is why I can go and speak to anyone, I don't care who you are, with 100% confidence about this concept. So, this experience, it's been 4 years that I've been building this idea. And once I made the decision to build it, it was exciting for me because I was like, all right, I've never done this before. It's a whole different animal. And I'm loving the learning. Even the losses and the hits that I took along the way, and I still take along the way, I enjoy every second of it. I got my first $20 check because I signed someone up. And I got it in the mail. And I was so excited. I took that $20 check and I put it on the refrigerator. And I put two zeros next to it. 2,000 was going to be my next goal. I just wanted to make $2,000 a month. Now, if you're a guest in this room and you have a job or something, you have a career, raise your hand. Okay, great. Now, to my guests in the room, in terms of how much money you make, are you able to double, triple, quadruple that in the next 12 months with your current job? Anybody say yes? Raise your hand if it's a yes. Quadruple it. Any yeses? Can you quadruple it? You can. Tell me how. What do you do?
I got a call. Growing.
Well, what do you do, ma'am? What do you do? What'd she say?
Working.
You're working with babies. Oh, so you have like a child care service? How do you quadruple your income in the next 12 months?
She brings more kids.
What does that mean? How do you do it? How do you earn four times the amount of money you're making right now in the next 12 months? How do you do that in child care? Okay. She just said, I think it's impossible. Okay? Now watch this. Because most vehicles that we're driving can't do that. Most financial vehicles that we drive, whether it's a job, I don't care if you have your own child care service, if you're a doctor, a lawyer, an accountant, there's only 24 hours in a day and there's only one of you. There's only so much mileage you can get out of that. So here's why I got excited, because I said, here's my first $20 check. One day it's going to be $2,000. Bless you. It's going to be $2,000 a month, one day. If I just keep showing this idea, if I just keep expanding it, because I knew it was going beyond myself. So even though to the outside world, $20? You been in this thing for 3 weeks and all you made is $20? You can work a job at McDonald's for 3 weeks and make more than that. I was like, but you don't understand. It's compound. It's going to grow over time. Listen, you have 2 degrees. You have a master's from Yale. You are earning $12,000 an hour as a speaker. And you talking about $20? What is wrong with you? I was like, Mom, be patient. I know it sounds crazy. I know it doesn't look right. I know everything, every fiber in your being is saying, this is wrong. It doesn't make sense. I get it. Just trust me on this one. Just trust me on this one. She didn't want to trust me. She was very upset. She started calling my friends. I think there's something wrong with him.